Yeah, I know.
Smoking, I honestly can't tell exactly how hot it is, but I'm pretty sure it's hot. Want to touch it with your tongue and see?
Probably not. You can see the steam coming up.
I don't see the steam.
Or
the
heat or something.
Heat? And maybe it's cold air in the building. Turn this on. Oh, I need a helmet. Is it even working right now?
You want the other one?
Battery in this piece. problem. Hondo. Yeah, this one. Jig weld, right? Over here on the jig.
Alright.
Your welder, they screw around with your numbers. They don't work the same. So I'll give it a contaminated turtle on here. I don't want it. It's hard welding from that direction, too. You know, the head is so cold, it doesn't want to melt. It needs some help. Probably got a bond up as well. Pulsing really bad. I don't think I'll be half long. It's really working well.
Yeah.
Definitely got to work on the welder to figure out why it's pulsing so bad. Real suck to weld. Plus I'm welding my left hand backwards, which is always fun to do. Anyway, it's on there. You notice how you put the argon in there, it doesn't turn so black all of a sudden?
Mm-hmm.
Amazing how that works. So the edge is all in there, that's all we cared about, that little nick that was in there. Should be all right. So this does a couple things. It compresses the hot metal into the part, but also if I didn't quite have enough material right next to the bead, if I beat it in, it'll shove it in a little bit further and cover up the little nick when you machine it. So it'll cover it up even if I didn't have quite enough. The biggest thing is we don't want to have a low spot right next to where your weld is to here, because that defeats the purpose of having what we want. Plus you have that steel insert right in there, so when I beat on that, it actually shoves aluminum that way as you come on it. So it'll help keep that insert tight, because you don't want that to unscrew, obviously, either. So that's why you beat things a little bit. Now that valve guide needs to come out of there, but we didn't take that out yet, because we didn't have a tool for it. But we're going to get ourselves a tool. Okay, let's get up front. Get out of the way. Mm-hmm. This is hot. Up the air in front of my face. Definitely warm. Good time to knock out that bad guy.
Thank God.
Hi, Scooby. Did you like that big pop we did earlier? Steel hammer behind you there. He just appreciated it like crazy.
Oh, yeah.
So, Scooby. Scooby's happy now. That thing is still in there, even though it's that hot. That guy does not want to come out of there. Weld it in there. See how the aluminum galled all the way up?
Mm-hmm.
It's tight. I'm surprised it didn't break off the half like that and try to beat it out sideways. It actually stayed assembled all the way out, which is good. But yeah, that aluminum stuck, so it screwed the hole up coming out. So that'll take an oversized guide. Going back in. You can see the top of the hole was screwed up by this side too, so see how the torn metal here coming out?
Yeah.
When they stick like that, it really screws things up when they come out. That was well stuck in there. Nothing you can do about it, you just beat it and get out. It's hard to cut them out because you've screwed the head up even worse. So now we got that. Which size hole was that going to be?
Here's the seat.
I'm going to put the seat in right now. Beat in a guide. How big of a guide are we going to beat in there is the question. Is that an intake or an exhaust? Whatever this is. Mm-hmm. tight. That was a 3-over. That was a 3-over guide in a standard hole. Hot. So when that cools off, it's going to be
tight.
And hopefully the hole kind of re-smudged itself into some kind of a round hole. Yeah, definitely in there. Okay, so now we got this one over here. We're going to try a standard. Because this hole isn't all screwed up. If that was cold, that'd be tight, but not super tight. But being hot, it'll cool off and it'll get even tighter, so it'll be fine. So the exhaust is standard. The intake one is all screwed up because of that one's all screwed up. So now, head is cooling off. So I don't know, we're going to wind up being on that seat. So we can't do anything until I hone the guide out, because the pilot won't go in there. If it's very, if this guide is slightly off center at all, the seat won't go in there anyway.
It fell up.
It'll be it's going to want to break my pilot off. It won't have enough room to bend over to go in. So that's a good way to bend a pilot, which is the last thing I really want to do. Still, all right, well, we'll let this cool off a little bit and we'll be back.